You're listening to Radio Owlsnest. The songs of Martin Page, all day, all night, forever. So grab a cup of tea, settle down with us in the Owlsnest. I hope you've got your cup of tea. I hope you're in the mood to hibernate with me. That rhymed. That rhymed. I'm a talented soul. It's Radio Owlsnest episode 8. hard to believe, isn't it? But it is. And this is where I become very egocentric and play all my songs from my career, from my history. Nobody else's songs, nobody else's material, just mine. I control the suitcase and the vault and the archive. So all you're going to hear for the next 50 minutes or so are my odds and sods, lots of rarities, and maybe one or two brand new pieces. I got to say thank you to all you OwlHeads for actually tuning in and being there. Let's start off with a song from 1996. That sounds like a good time to start. My favourite number is 3, 9 and 6. So 1996, a track I wrote for a movie called Phenomenon, a movie that starred John Travolta. It was a song called Dance with Life, in brackets, The Brilliant Light, and it was written with Bernie Taupin. Here's the demo I did on a 16-track tape recorder in my garage, which really is the Owlsnest as well, where we're recording this today. So have a listen to the demo. I'll tell you some more details about the song after, but here it is. Dance with Life, The Brilliant Light.
Swim in the soul of your eyes and
Can I tell you about Dance with Life, The Brilliant Light? Some facts here that you might find interesting. When I finished the demo, Robbie Robertson of band fame said, could we change the lyrics to the front verse? And I had to reach out to Bernie and see if he would change the lyrics to the first verse, because they wanted the first verse to be even more intimate. Bernie did it, like in about 30 seconds, sent it back to me, and I dropped in the new lead vocal on the 16-track tape recorder. When we sent it back, everybody was happy, and then the song went out to the world to see who was going to sing it, and Robbie Robertson waited to see who leapt at it. Well, Sinead O'Connor was the first person who showed tremendous interest in it, but as you know, it eventually fell into the hands of Brian Ferry, and Trevor Horn produced the actual record. It was a single from the album. I remember Trevor Horn calling me and saying, it's too long. This song is just too bloody long. How do we cut it down? And so I did some experiments on my little DAT player in my studio, and I sent the results to Trevor, and he cut the song up, and it became slightly shorter. I think from 20 minutes it came down to 16, something like that. Trevor Horn used actually my drum beat that I put on the demo that you can hear here. And this drum beat I've used before on a song called I Guess I Will. For all you owl heads out there that look deeply into these things, yes, I've used that drum loop a few times in my career. The album that Dance With Life was on did incredibly well. It was loved by all, and amazingly for a soundtrack, went on to be platinum. And the film became very successful. I'm very partial to this song. I feel very emotional about it. And in some ways, I like the demo better than the actual record. But that's just me. I like the moody, hidden vibe of this song. The sort of, I don't know, blue clouds coming over and enveloping in the chorus and giving the mood of what the lyrics are all about. And my good friend, Brian Fairweather, the guitarist from the early days in Q.Feel and my songwriting partner in the later years, he played the guitar you hear here on the demo, which I think is particularly emotional and quite exquisite for a Scotsman. Another very fascinating fact, I think, is, as I mentioned before, the lyric to the first verse was changed for the movie version and the Trevor Horn version. But Colin Blunstone recorded Dance With Life on an album called The Ghost of You and Me, and he sings the original first verse lyric by Bernie. That means he must have got a very, very early cassette of the demo of this song. So if you want to check out the original Bernie Taupin lyrics on Dance With Life, go and have a listen to Colin Blunstone's version, that great singer from the Zombies, on an album called The Ghost of You and Me. Well, there we are. I hope some of those facts are quite new to you regarding a song that's close to my heart. Let's liven it up somewhat. Here's a song called All Too Human, and it's from my album Hotel of the Two Worlds. And I always imagined a singer like Robert Palmer could have murdered this. Okay, All Too Human.
I'm too human.
I had a lot of fun recording the album Hotel of the Two Worlds. I wanted to get back to my R&B, rhythm and blues roots, and playing the bass and just letting myself fall into the groove and the groove running the show. So that's a song called All Too Human from my album Hotel of the Two Worlds. And there actually was a Hotel of the Two Worlds back in Paris in France in the 1900s, which was supposed to be haunted, and people called it the Hotel of the Two Worlds. See, you learn something new every day at Radio Owlsnest. Well, let's use that very cheap reverb and echo for effect here, because we are going to go into... We are going to go walking down the grimy steps, through the cobwebs, see the ghosts scattering left and right, into pools of water sloshing through into the darkness. And there we find an incredible rarity that I haven't played for yonkers, which means from the beginning of time. I really didn't even know I had this in my archive still. I dug into the cassettes, and lo and behold, a song called Closer to the Edge, written with Bernie Taupin. I think right back when Bernie and I just started writing, probably very, very soon after we wrote We Built the City and These Dreams together, which were the first two songs we wrote. Then I think I wrote this bugger. Beautiful little piece, I think, sung by Tommy Funderburg, that incredible session musician who I made friends with when I first dropped into LA. This is just me on an 8-track with Tommy and keyboards and drum machine, a rarity from the vault, Closer to the Edge.
I must have took a wrong turn, I got myself boxed in, now I feel the ropes behind. Trapped within this ring, got to be so holy, got to be a saint sometimes. When we break the vows we made, we stray across that line, slipping in the darkness, deep inside our heads. Each one knows the other's getting closer to the edge. I swore your lips were crimson. Sweat soaked the sheets we were locked in. Our bodies broke in prison. You got to have the passion. You got to have the drive to love. As soon as doubt attacks us, half a heart ain't enough.
Hope you enjoyed listening to that as much as I did, and also finding it. That was a hell of a surprise. You dig into a huge box of cassettes, pull one out, and there's a title on there, Closer to the Edge, that you can vaguely remember. That's Closer to the Edge, a very, very early demo with Bernie Taupin writing the lyrics, and that was cassette time.
Here are true facts about the owl. Despite its cuddly appearance beneath those fluffy feathers, the owl is what we call a bird of prey, because it eats prey. Just as the owls call us apes of the hamburger, because we eat hamburgers.
Here's a song I wrote in the year 1989. A lot of stuff happened in the 80s for me, didn't it? I wrote this with Jonathan Cain, yes, of Journey fame, and the great singer John Waite. I fell in love with his vocals, hearing them right back in the 70s when he was with the Babies. We got together at my house when they were forming a band called Bad English. A lot of bad Englishmen together in my garage at that time. And here is a song called Ghost in Your Heart. I'll tell you a little bit about it after.
Tearing you apart. You're gonna raise a family now, but you don't know where to start. I remember you and me. I pack a suitcase, move from town to town. Little east of Eden, too late to turn around. Marionettes and wires, we dance out of control. I remember you. Slipped right through our hands. search your reflection. You sometimes see my face. You remember too. I remember you. Are you crying in your sleep tonight? When you're lying with him, do you turn out the light? Are you hiding in your dreams tonight? In your world? Are you crying in your sleep tonight? Are you lying with him, thinking about me tonight?
That demo was done all in an afternoon. When John Waite and Jonathan Cain arrived at my house, it was like, let's write a song instantly. And that's what we did. I had the essence of a groove starting, and I played that to them live, and they said yes. So John Waite went into my living room while I developed the demo, and he wrote the words, listening to the music through the garage door inside. Not outside, inside. I remember playing, if you can, imagine this, a live Lin drum. That's a drum machine, a robotic drum machine. And I was putting down all the fills and all programming it at live as it went along. So all the drum fills you hear, I'm sort of just going for it like I'm a real drummer. Jonathan Cain liked the vibe I had, and he sort of left most of the song to me. But he did contribute to the solo and like the last verse with some lovely keyboards, some nice inflections, which were rather tasty. The song became the lead track on side two of their debut album, Bad English, and that album went on to do very well, a platinum album again, and I think with that song, When I See You Smile, which John Waite didn't actually really want to be a first single, and I don't think he really, really wanted it to be a song that he actually sang, but he did, and it led that album to huge success. I've said this millions of times before, but John Waite has that character, that amazing phrasing in his vocal that I think makes him one of England's greatest soul singers, soul rock singers. I think he resides with all those Paul Rodgers and those Robert Palmers and in a very rarefied atmosphere. That's a song called... What's it called again? Let me have a look down here. Yes, okay. I've written a lot of songs with ghost in the title. This is called Ghost in Your Heart. Got it right eventually. The owls are telling me to look up at the studio clock here, well, the Pro Tools timer, and it says 29 minutes, 25 seconds. So that means we're at the midway stage. And what better time to go for the almighty, glorious, and so loved quiz. So here's an interesting question. A few of you out there might know, this is question one for 50 points, that I played keyboards on, wait for it, thank you, Ghostbusters with Ray Parker. And I used a very unusual, cheap, and rather unknown keyboard. I won't ask you the actual model name of the keyboard, but I'll ask you who made that keyboard. The one keyboard that I played on the single Ghostbusters, and a little bit in the actual movie with ghost scenes when Sigourney Weaver is lying there being molested by a ghost, that's my creepy sounds. What's the unusual keyboard? The name of the company that made the keyboard that I played on Ghostbusters. Now, I've mentioned it in quite a few interviews, because that's what I do. I just keep talking about myself and what I've done. So see if you know what that keyboard is. Question two. Now, this is really bloody hard, really hard. I'll be amazed if anybody gets this one. So let's see. Tough question coming. I had a song recorded by The Temptations lead singer, and his name is Dennis Edwards. What's the name of the song that he recorded of mine? What song did Dennis Edwards, the singer of The Temptations, record of mine? That's a bloody tough one. My hats are off to you. Well, my hat is off to you. I haven't got many hats on. My hat is off to you if you get that right.
Hi, this is Trevor Thornton here, and you're listening to Radio Owlsnest with Martin Page, where you'll only hear Martin Page songs all day and all night long. God, what torture.
What is it about drummers? You know, what is it about drummers? They sit behind you and they're playing along to all your songs and looking quite content. Then when they get a chance, like Trevor Thornton does, the drummer of Q.Feel, he insults me. Ah, drummers, a strange lot indeed. Let's get in the time machine and travel all the way back to, let's push a button here, 2012. Let's try that. I made an album called A Temper of Peace, and it was very, for me, very folk influenced. I've been playing soccer with Robbie Williams, and he said that he was looking to do a folk album. Yes, strange, a folk album. So he said, come up to my house with your acoustic guitar and play. Let's start writing. So I did. I brought my acoustic guitar up to his house and we started to write a few songs which definitely had that folky feel to it. And I went into quite a deep study of brilliant folk music. It was a wonderful time to go deep into that territory where I'd really never really ventured before. But my heritage being down on the south coast in Southampton, near the New Forest, of course, and near the sea, it was in me, I suppose. And a few songs on A Temper of Peace definitely had that lilt. And here's a track called Ruby Ray. And although there's not tons of acoustic guitars in this song, and I did go more into a synthesizer ambient feel, it's a very pastoral feel about it. And it's about a girl. Yes, Ruby Ray, she has red hair, and by God, she has fire in her heart.
Ruby Ray, it's summer time again. There's laughter in your eye. You're running through the fair. Oh, I can see your long scarlet hair. So wild and free, ablaze you come to me. A spirit burning red. Oh Lord, I can't forget the kiss that never ever left my lips. Here's a story about a girl who stole the sun, and with her smile she could enchant everyone. Without a word, all heads would turn when she passed your way. Ruby Ray, it's summertime again. There's laughter in your eye, and you're running through the fair. Oh, I can see your long scarlet hair, so wild and free. Ablaze you come to me, a spirit burning red. Oh Lord, I can't forget the kiss that never ever left my lips. Now, Father Riley, he said the child can't be tamed. The devil's inside her. She's desire unchained. Well, just imagine, come away. If sin is passion, then lead me astray. Ruby Ray, it's summertime again. There's laughter in your eye. You're running through the fair. I can see your long scarlet hair, so wild and free. Ablaze you come to me, a spirit burning red. Oh Lord, I can't forget the kiss that never ever left my lips. Thank you.
time again. There's laughter in your eye. You're running through the fair. Oh, I can see your long scarlet hair, so wild and free. The blaze you come to me, a spirit burning red. Oh Lord, I can't forget the kiss that never ever left my lips. Ruby red. Oh, it's summertime again. Time again, for you and me, ruby red. It's summertime again.
That's Ruby Ray from my 2012 album, A Temper of Peace. I would have liked to have met Ruby Ray. Oh, yes, I'd have liked to have met her. A bit of a ramble away in the old haystacks there, but I think she would have broken my heart. There's no doubt about it, actually. That's Ruby Ray. If you listen carefully to the background vocals, that's authentic Gaelic Old English language. So, nice touch, eh? Oh my God! That must mean that something incredibly important is about to happen. Get your helmets on. Something incredibly important must be about to happen. Well, we're going to go back to... Yes! Wait for it, everybody. We're going right back to that special era. The 80s. Well, after all that hoopla, we promised you something special. I better deliver. This is a demo for Q.Feel. It didn't go on to the Q.Feel album, but I did develop it when I came to LA, right in the early days. It's a track called No Man's Land. Just me with the old drum machine and a Fostex 8-track. And I was developing this for a future Q.Feel record. At the time that I was writing We Built the City and These Dreams with Bernie Taupin, I was doing stuff on the edge as well for Q.Feel. And this is the result of that. Very raw, first time heard. In fact, when I finished it, I played it to Kim Carnes, and she said, I need to do this. But she didn't. But here is the demo, a Q.Feel demo from the 80s called No Man's Land.
Show your flag if I wanted to. I bet I could make you drop your guard if I needed to. And then I would take you by surprise, interrogate your eyes if I wanted to. I could just make you move your lines if I chose to. Well, who needs enemies when I got you? When I go over with the waves, tell me that it's sad. Cause I feel I'm walking into no man's land. Shattered hearts lying on the ground. Life will fall where the soldier stands. Someone's lost down in no man's land. I better dig in deep with you. Can we agree to hold and talk it out? Holding your head from north to south, let's work it out. I'm letting you bend me into shape, bend me anywhere I let you want to. How could you let me play the fool to get to you? Catch me in the wire and run me through. When I go over with the waves,
tell me that it's safe, 'cause I feel I'm walking into no man's land. Shattered hearts lying on the ground. Love will fall where the soldiers dance. Someone's lost down in no man's land. I've been digging deep with you. I could make you show your flag if I wanted to. And I could make you drop your guard if I needed to. When I go over with the waves, tell me that it's safe, 'cause I feel I'm walking into no man's land. Shattered hearts lying on the ground. Love will fall where the soldiers dance.
First time aired, first time heard. That's a demo from the archives, a Q.Feel demo. I was writing it right back at the beginning of the 80s, thinking it would go on to a future Q.Feel record, but we broke up, so it didn't. I recorded it on a quarter-inch Fostex 8-track, and it was all done on a Jupiter 8. All those little quirky noises was me programming away like a wild man on the Roland famous Jupiter 8. And that's a rarity that came from... Thank you, Igo. You're such a fan of the 80s, still wearing his flares.
Here are true facts about the owl.
This owl is an ambush hunter. What makes her so deadly? She's not the fastest, but she has a different advantage. It's stealth, not speed, that makes her lethal.
Yes, I've known a lot of girlfriends just like that. I was just thinking that this particular show, I've been talking about Bernie Taupin a great deal. And why not? And it made me think that looking into the archives, I might pull out a demo of one of the songs that I wrote with Bernie for his solo album in 1987, an album called Tribe. I wrote all the songs with him and I produced the album. And I wrote all the songs possibly with him in about a period of 3 weeks. And I've delved into the old archive and I did find a demo that I did for Bernie to listen to, a song called I Still Can't Believe That You're Gone. I did, when I was writing some of these songs for Bernie, I did some of the guide vocals and did little demos for him and took them up to his house and we worked it out on the piano and all that stuff, and he told me his keys and how he'd like to change a few things or whatever. But Bernie basically sent me all the lyrics in one big go. We'd had those hits writing together in the past, and he said, let's try something for him. It was a great album to do, particularly for me, because I was able to bring in some terrific musicians to work live on the tracks. But here is the demo that I did myself on an 8-track to take up to Bernie to see if he was happy with it and if he wanted to record it. This is a song called I Still Can't Believe That You're Gone.
In your shoes, I can't believe that you do this to me. No, I just can't believe that you're gone. What am I supposed to do? One is not as fun as two. No, I still can't believe that you're
demo from 1987, a song called I Still Can't Believe That You're Gone. I wrote that with Bernie Taupin. This show seems to have a lot of roads leading to Bernie. And as I said before, why not? It brought back some great memories of writing all those songs on his album Tribe. We wrote them very quickly. I mean, literally, he just gave me a folder of the lyrics and bang, we were off. Those were the days when things just did seem to move at quite a pace. Not now, with my wheelchair and my walking stick. Things are a little bit slower. But writing with Bernie, as you can imagine, because I grew up with all those Elton John albums, and Goodbye Yellow Brick Road is one of my favourite albums of all time, in my top five, actually. So writing with Bernie, as you can imagine, was a pretty special time. And talking about Bernie, I'm getting quite nostalgic here and thinking of all the wonderful people that have surrounded me during my long career and are still around me now, thank goodness. There's one gentleman that's not around me anymore and I miss profoundly, and that is Mike Shipley, the engineer that worked with me right from the beginning on Dancing in Heaven with the Q.Feel record, right on to even In the House of Stone and Light. He mixed that whole album. He's a lovely man. Lovely man. He's nearly as tall as me, or maybe taller than me. And he had a great sense of humour. When I was told, the day I was told that he'd passed on, I was shook up pretty badly. And I went into the studio maybe a couple of hours later, and out came this song, because I'd quite recently worked with him on a Josh Groban album. I produced Josh Groban on a song called Mi Morena. And Mike had mixed that. I'll tell you a little bit about that, how that all turned out and how this song came about after you hear a song about my good friend, Mike Shipley. This song is called Golden.
So golden, yeah.
That's a song called Golden, written for my friend, Mike Shipley. And that came from my 2015 album, Hotel of the Two Worlds. There's a few clues about Mike's life and my friendship with him in the song. It starts off with those lyrics, being in Islington and Mike picking me up in his Volkswagen. And we went to Battery Studios in London to record my first real work with Q.Feel. So he was there right at the beginning. And also on the end there, I wanted to sing the chorus of House of Stone and Light again, because I think he helped that make it a big hit for me. It was always magic to be in the studio with him, and that's why in a lot of ways in the verses I portray what it was to be with the maestro, really. He was a real scientist of sound. Why I called the song Golden was when we were mixing that Josh Groban track, it was all in digital. And although I'd recorded the record on analog on a Studio 24 track, and Mike wanted to mix it in digital because he'd been working in Pro Tools for maybe the last few years. But I wasn't happy with the sound. So I asked him if we could do it, mix it analog onto two 24 track machines, and he was reticent at the beginning and said no way, but eventually he did. And when we finished that old-fashioned mix of the two 24 track analog tape machines moving together, I asked him if he enjoyed the feeling of going back to where we started on analog music, and he said golden. It was golden, mate. And that stuck in my mind, because a lot of things about working with Mike Shipley were golden. There it is. That is the reminder that I need to now excite you all and move your souls and make you ponder for life with the quote of the show. And I particularly like this quote a lot. So here we go. It comes from Albert Schweitzer. Think occasionally of the suffering of which you spare yourself the sight. Lovely. Ha ha ha, the kettle is boiling. This is a long show. I've gone over an hour. Can't quite believe that. It went so fast to me. Probably incredibly slow to you. But the kettle tells me it's time to wrap everything up. It has been a nostalgic show for me. I started to remember everybody that made a lot of those songs with me and were involved. And I'd like to put a shout out and thank Vanessa Levitt, the lovely lady that helps me with my Facebook page. My long-suffering manager, Diane Poncher, been my partner right from the very, 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 very beginning of time. And there's a chappie called David Knight who's been doing all the artwork, and I call him the painter of the senses. A lot of the visuals you see around my work, it's to do with that Canadian up there, David Knight. Thank you, guys. Now, no show of mine would be finishing properly if I didn't plead for the innocent animals out there. Please show kindness and compassion to our fellow brothers and sisters, the furry brothers and sisters. We have dominion over them, so it's our responsibility to look after them. And if you get a chance, bring home an animal from the shelter. I know in my own experience, having animals in my family around me made me, I think, a slightly better person. Okay, I will see you again, I hope, very soon in the Owl's Nest. Bye-bye.